ever since this lockdown situation started, I was kind of happy about staying at home all the time. And I started working out a lot and doing everything healthy. I exercised to a point that my sister came and told me to stop and that I was overdoing it. But after a point, I realized that this staying at home vacation is not for a short time and we have no idea that when is all of this going to end. And I slowly, steadily stopped working out and started overeating. Like really, a lot. After waking up in the morning, I didn't work out and because of that, I didn't feel hungry to eat breakfast. And because of that, I started eating some junk food right in the morning. Which is not like myself at all because I at least make sure that I start my day with eating something wholesome which is not processed. I hated myself so much for it. I knew in my mind that I was full and I didn't need to eat that much because I was barely even moving and sitting around all day. So I clearly didn't need to eat that much. The reality is that we are not accustomed to being at home for 24 hours a day, not going out at all, not meeting any of your friends for such a long period of time. And I was clearly boredom eating and I needed to stop, but I wasn't able to. At this point, I started thinking that can food be so addictive? Not in a funny sense addictive, but in a clinical symptom sense addictive. Well, it turns out that food industry is very secretive about all of these food being addictive and they spend thousands of dollars on making food more quote-unquote appealing to us. They spend a lot of time in making sure that the ratio of three golden foods, which are fat, sugar and salt, is perfect. Remember how it felt so comforting and nice after hitting your favorite brand and flavor of that ice cream or chips into your tongue? It was manufactured to feel that way. Comment below, what is your favorite binge eating snack and let's see how many of us like junk food for binge eating. They added flavor enhancers to make you taste the flavors which don't even exist in their products. They spent hours to perfect the crispiness of those chips to give you that exact feeling in your mouth between your teeth when you chew it. They make such perfect combinations of salt, sugar and fat that you will keep craving their products and you just can't help but eat more. These kinds of fat, sugar and salt combinations don't exist in nature because it is not healthy for your body. And this makes replacing these processed foods with natural food alternatives that much more difficult. On top of everything, they are easy to find anywhere. They have a lot of shelf life and they are made so convenient to eat and buy and carry everywhere. All these things are like add-ons on these foods being addictive. Our ancestors only ate foods which were available in the nature and hence reward sensors in our brain are designed that way. Hence, whatever food we eat, which is high in sugar, salt and fat, we feel good. Because activity in your brain's reward sensor is increased and a feel-good chemical named dopamine is released. After a while of eating such processed foods, our brain needs more amount of food to release the same amount of dopamine. And we start eating more and more of that food and this starts turning into a vicious cycle of food addiction. Many people are diagnosed by this disorder medically. I said that just to clear out to people who are going to say that food addiction is not real. So to deal with binge eating habit for myself, I just simply started working out like I used to. This acts like a habit cue to me. Whenever I work out, I end up doing healthier things all day. If you want to know about Power of Habits, just read a book which is named Power of Habits written by Charles Duhigg. I also reduce munching and snacking in between breakfast, lunch and dinner. Even if I do snack, I just take a small portion of it in a plate rather than eating the whole thing out of the bag. Now I know these tips sound very basic and have nothing over there fancy, but sometimes little things make big changes. I'm not saying that I have full control over it, but I'm taking baby steps to stop my habit of binge eating. And these three simple steps have helped me a lot towards overcoming that habit. Hope you all find this video at least a little helpful. Please subscribe to my channel for more such weekly content. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you all next week. Bye!